Okay, so the third topic for today is Android phones breaking due to wallpaper. Now, this is a
That can only happen in Android,
guys. I don't know, it can happen as iOS, but they have a lot of QC checks, okay. So, all this happened because of one pixel. One pixel in that photo.
One pixel, really?
One pixel, yeah. So, there was this photographer who clicked a picture on his Nikon camera and then edited it through Lightroom. And so,
yeah, when I read this article.
Yeah. So, while exporting the picture, Lightroom gives you multiple options and there are color schemes as well.
Classic.
Yeah, so he chose Pro Photo RGB instead of sRGB, and Android phones have sRGB as their standard format, and I don't think they support the Pro Photo RGB. And so this photo, the way Android deals with wallpaper is there is an engine which is responsible for putting the wallpaper on your screen. And so specifically that was not updated to support the Pro Photo RGB or the standard. It is just sRGB. And so what happened is, okay, so this is gonna get a little bit complex, though thoda
aisa
technical. Stay with us. When you set a wallpaper or view a wallpaper, the phone has to decide the individual luminance of each pixel, which is calculated based on the RGB value. Uske upar ka.
Value.
And so basically the sRGB standard has the value from 0 to 255. But the Pro Photo RGB has extra information in it. So when the phone was trying to calculate it for the wallpaper, the value was coming out to be 256. And it can only have from 0 to 255. So there is a process called Image Processor Helper. It continuously crashed because 256, it can't use that value. And so wallpaper is something that you view while your phone starts or something. It is something which is always there.
Right.
So it just caused the phone to crash again and again and boot loop as well, and so phones couldn't even start. So people had to go into safe mode and just wipe their entire phones as well. Some smart people figured out that if you delete the wallpaper from system wala ye and set a new wallpaper or change it to default wallpaper, it could be fixed. But we would not recommend you use that photo as your wallpaper. What you can do is click a screenshot, because Google Photos can do the conversion from photo RGB to sRGB, so you can just click a screenshot of that and set it.
The photo is actually pretty
smart.
Photo.
All this could have been fixed by three extra lines of code. So when I was viewing the file which was crashing again and again, I figured out having three lines of code. The first is check if it is more than 255. If it is more than 255, set the value as 255. So the only problem will be that light white and then ekdam complete white will look same. But at least your phone will work.
Very minute difference.
Very minute difference, but your phone will work. And this only happened on devices running Android 10 or lesser. The devices running Android 11. So in 11 they implemented a feature where if it doesn't recognize some format, it will convert it to sRGB, which is a smarter way of doing what I said, three lines of code. So Android 11 phones were safe, but as we all know, Android 11 kisi ke paas nahi hai because it's in beta and only Pixel users have it, most of them, or some of them, who were updated.
Right.
So yeah, but iPhones didn't have this problem at all. The guy who posted the picture on Flickr had 10,000 followers. And so he had an interview with BBC and he said that I didn't know this problem was caused because I use an iPhone. And that was his statement. And everyone was like, okay.
Ouch.
And so he also said that he wished he had gone viral for something good, but this is fine too. All PR is good PR, etc. And it's nice. Although I'm imagining the amount of problem that the people who set the wallpaper, because it's a really nice picture, let me tell you, it's a
really
scenic
nice
picture.
It's from the top of a hill or something.
Ha, exactly. And
he like waited for days on end to like click that picture at a certain time.
I didn't know.
I read the article.
He went there with his wife or something like that.
He went there with his wife.
But enough about him, about the guy who set it as a wallpaper for the first time. It sucks because now you can't turn on your phone, you don't know what's the problem, there are no Google answers to it, and you just have to reset your entire phone. And resetting your phone is a big problem now that we have our entire data on it, as well. Like gigs and gigs of data. And just setting it up again, downloading all the apps, setting them up. It is a big task, at least for me. I remember I used to have ROMs on my phone, trying different ROMs as well.
Oh my god.
And it was a process to just set up after every new ROM.
Oh my god. I had tinkered in that for a while, but I was like, risk nahi lena.
Oh, after a point, I just figured out a smarter way to do it. Don't keep anything on your phone. Sub cloud pe rakho.
That's right.
That's an easy way to do it.
Yeah.
And I had fast internet everywhere I went, so it wasn't a problem.
Hmm. That's nice. That's convenient.
So yeah, don't set that as a wallpaper. Anyway.
And don't use Lightroom.
Oh. Don't use that photo format.
Export it sRGB, dumb dumb.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh my god.
Chalo, anyway. Cool.